This is Duke University.
Thank you. light and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord. Tonight I report the sad news that distinguished author and longtime English professor Reynolds Price has passed away this afternoon. Let us pause for a moment of silence to remember all those who love him. Please join me in the collect for light. Almighty God, we give you thanks for surrounding us as daylight fades with the brightness of your vesper light. And we implore you of your great mercy that as you enfold us with the radiance of this light, so you would shine into our hearts the brightness of your Holy Spirit. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Old Testament lesson is from Malachi, the fourth chapter. See, the day is coming, burning like an oven, when all the arrogant and all evildoers will be stubble. The day that comes shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts, so that it will leave them neither root nor branch. But for you who revere my name, the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in its wings. You shall go out leaping like calves from the stall, and you shall tread down the wicked, for they will be like ashes under the soles of your feet on the day when I act, says the Lord of hosts. Remember the teaching of my servant Moses, the statutes and ordinances that I commanded him at Horeb for all Israel. Lo, I will send you the prophet Elijah before the great and terrible day of the Lord comes. He will turn the hearts of parents to their children and the hearts of children to their parents, so that I will not come and strike the land with a curse. This is the word of the Lord. The 11th chapter. I ask then, has God rejected his people? By no means. I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. God has not rejected his people, whom he foreknew. Do you not know what the scripture says of Elijah, how he pleads with God against Israel? Lord, they've killed your prophets, they've demolished your altars. I alone am left, and they're seeking my life. But what is the divine reply to him? I have kept for myself 7,000 who have not bowed the knee to Baal. So too at the present time there is a remnant chosen by grace. But if it is by grace, it is no longer on the basis of works. Otherwise, grace would no longer be grace. This is the word of the Lord.
Come, spend in my hope, he's on the team, but the set is my song.
please stand for the reading of the gospel? The lesson is from the Gospel of Luke, the first chapter. In the days of King Herod of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah who belonged to the priestly order of Abijah. His wife was a descendant of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. Both of them were righteous before God, living blamelessly according to all the commandments and regulations of the Lord. But they had no children, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were getting on in years. Once when Zechariah was serving as priest before God and his section was on duty, he was chosen by lot, according to the custom of the priesthood, to enter the sanctuary of the Lord and offer incense. Now at the time of the incense offering, the whole assembly of the people was praying outside. Then there appeared to him an angel of the Lord standing at the right side of the altar of incense. When Zechariah saw him, he was terrified, and fear overwhelmed him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, for your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you will name him John. You will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He must never drink wine or strong drink. Even before his birth, he will be filled with the Holy Spirit. He will turn many of the people of Israel to the Lord, their God. With the spirit and power of Elijah, he will go before him to turn the hearts of parents to their children and the disobedient to the wisdom of the righteous, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord." Zechariah said to the angel, "How will I know that this is so? For I'm an old man, and my wife is getting on in years." The angel replied, "I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and to bring you this good news. But now, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled in their time, you will become mute, unable to speak, until the day these things occur." Meanwhile, the people were waiting for Zechariah and wondered at his delay in the sanctuary. When he did come out, he could not speak to them, and they realized that he had seen a vision in the sanctuary. He kept motioning to them and remained unable to speak. When his time of service was ended, he went to his home. After those days, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and for 5 months she remained in seclusion. She said, "This is what the Lord has done for me when he looked favorably on me and took away the disgrace I have endured among my people." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Lord God, in the reading from Malachi, we hear of a day when the sun will rise and shine with the bright light of righteousness, bringing healing to those who honor you. Embrace in this hour any who have not seen this healing light. Comfort any who have been hurt or broken by the unrighteousness or injustice of others. Cherish any damaged or abused by people proclaiming your name. Where our injustice and unrighteous attitudes or actions have been the source of pain for people close to us, correct and forgive us. Redirect and look with mercy on any whose ways are wicked or arrogant, that your grace and righteousness might shine brighter still. We remember any who are estranged with their parents or children. Heal any physical or emotional wounds present in these relationships and open the path to forgiveness. Mend any relationships fractured by distrust, distance, or destructive words. May the presence of your Spirit be a reconciling balm in any troubled relationship. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, Paul reminds us of your faithfulness to your chosen people. We give thanks that in your grace you have not forsaken those you love. May the people of Israel find confidence in your goodness. Provide your peace in situations of political and social unrest in the Middle East and in Africa. Protect women and men and children whose lives are disrupted by violence and war in Pakistan and Palestine and Tunisia. Give hope to all who put their trust in you. Mend the hearts of any who feel rejected or forsaken by a friend, a family member, or your church. Reassure and restore with your mercy and grace all who have a deep sense of failure and regret. Lift up those bound by despair. We name the people of Brazil and Australia. Protect them today from the floods and mudslides that continue to threaten their homes and businesses. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, the gospel lesson reminds us that you surprise your children with good news. We praise you for the gift of children and the joy and gladness their births bring. We offer to your care couples who, like Elizabeth and Zechariah, are struggling to conceive. Comfort any who know the pain of losing a child through miscarriage or stillbirth. Nurture women for whom pregnancy is full of anxiety and struggle and pain. When we, like Zechariah, respond to the message of your good news in fear or doubt or disbelief, open our hearts to the grandeur and wonder of your good will toward us. Open your servants to your calling. Enable us to receive your purposes for us with joy. Correct us when our vision of your way in the world is limited by the obstacles we see, and make us bold to live in your power rather than our own. Lord, in your mercy. We offer this prayer in Jesus' name, saying the prayer he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. crucifixion, I have one quick announcement. On Sunday afternoon at 3 p.m., the Duke Vespers Ensemble, as well as the Vocal Arts Ensemble of Durham, will present a concert of Jewish choral music, which will premiere a new piece by Alan Friedman. Alan Friedman and Rodney Weinkoop will be conducting this concert. It is going to be held at the Judea Reformed Congregation in Durham. Admission is free, and you all are welcome. Receive now this blessing. May the light of God's righteousness illuminate your paths, and may the blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and always.